the Blue Dog Zoo and Matthew's Dog Walks and different Equals Hated. I need to fix that stuff and get it I need to get everything all of my streams are recorded. It doesn't matter where I stream, which of my channels I stream from. It all goes to my Blue Dog Zoo account on YouTube. The videos of my dog walks. If anybody else, wants to see them, ever. But today is a special day. I was really excited because all four of my dogs came with me today. Blue, Jade, Bowie, Jade. There's Jade and Lady. Come on, you ready? Here we go. So I was really excited about that. Oh, Blue stepped on a goat head again. You okay, buddy? Let me get that goat head. Come here. He got two of them today. Wait, Blue. All right, never mind. Okay, never mind. I'm sorry, dude. You okay? Blue, I can get it. You okay? Let me get it out of your foot. Come on, man. Blue, you can't walk with a goat head in your foot. Oh, come on, please. Blue's walking with a goat head in his foot. If he gets spooked, he won't let me touch him. It's frustrating. Darn it. I gotta cross the street here. I started the stream a little early. I usually start when I'm over there already. This is what I have to cross, though. I have to cross this crazy street. People just, drive like maniacs here. Come on, let's go. Right here. Right here is where my first dog, got hit and died in my arms right here on the ground in the middle of the road. Her name was Baby. I named her after Baby in, House of a Thousand Corpses and The Devil's Rejects. I really like horror films, and Devil's Rejects had just come out, and so I thought I'd name her after Baby from the movie. I know it's kind of a crazy, because she's such a weird baby in the movie, is such a weird psychopath, but I don't know. I just was like into it. Ah, dude, Jade's pooping. Okay, all right, so I gotta clean this up. I will just leave it sitting, not looking at what I'm doing, because what I'm doing is gross. Oh, Blue, you guys, don't pull me, please. I'm trying to get the poop. Don't pull me over. Don't pull me over. Every time a dog poops, all four of them pull away from the poop. They want to go, they want to get away from it as fast as they can, and I've got to pick it up, and so I'm trying to hold four dogs back while I clean up poop. I'm doing all this with one hand, this is just these amazing feats that I somehow pull off. I get one bag off of a roll of bags I have and hold back all four of them while I clean up the poo. It's great. Okay, let me get this again. Let me get it back to I'll switch it back to the dogs. And we'll get these dogs off the leashes in a minute here. Get them running around a little bit, I hope. Lady, of course, I always take off the leash. I don't know what they do. They do these weird things. And then they end up peeing on each other's heads and stuff. It's really gross. And then, of course, he kicks his pee dirt everywhere. That's these dogs, man. Crazy. They're kicking it at me and they're kicking it everywhere. Dude, there's some guy with a go-kart down here. Oh, that's great. It's I don't mind horses. Lady was like weird about horses. The first time she met a horse walking down here, she was really like unsure about the whole like thing, because it is such a, I mean, they're huge. So I just told her it was a really big dog, and she seemed to be okay with that. And she's just sort of spooked by them. She doesn't know what to make of them. I thought it was really interesting, like, you know, that, you know, just watching her interact with a horse. I was just afraid, honestly, I was afraid the horse was going to kick her, because horses, that's what they do. I mean, they just, like, if they feel threatened, they kick, and I was afraid that Lady was going to try and play with the dog, I mean, with the horse, and, you know, and, like, start, like, nipping at it, at its heels, you know, hurting it. And I was like, oh, dude, if she starts hurting this horse. Oh, Jade's got a goat head now. Dang it, man. Goat heads everywhere. Oh, Lord. Come here. Let me see. I'll get it. Did I get it? Wait, yep, I got it. There it is. I got it. That, man, that's already this walk has three goat heads. Lady, hey, come here, lady. Lady, come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. I'm going to get you. Hold on. Hold on, lady. Stop. Just stop, lady, stop. Stop, 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 lady. Stop walking. Lady, stop walking, dang it. She can hear the motor, and it sounds like a motorcycle. For some reason, she wants to herd motorcycles. I can't get her to freaking stop to take her collar. I want to take her leash off so I can get the other three untangled, because I get all tangled up. And if I can get Lady's leash out of there, I can get the other ones untangled. And then when I get a chance, then I can just let them go. But I got to get Lady off the leash first, and it means I got to get her to stop, which is not going to happen. Lady, can you stop? Lady, lady, just stop for a minute. Can you stop, please? Stop. Lady. She's obsessed with this go-kart over here. She's like, doesn't know what it is. And it's, like, she gets, like muscle cars confuse her, too. She gets really excited, but then when she sees it's just a muscle car, she's like, no big deal. Yeah, there goes the go-kart. So it's a pretty nice one, too, actually. Those things go like, you know, 25, 30 miles an hour. It's like two kids in there, you know, good thing they got a roll bar and like, you know, harnesses and stuff on. So, I've seen people do such dumb things with stuff like that, and it's so easy to flip those, and, hopefully those kids know how to drive it. Lady, if you stop, I'll let you off the leash. Lady, if you just stop for me, can you please stop? See, she won't stop. Lady. Lady, can you stop? Can you stop for me, please? Lady. Can you... Lady, come on, just stop. Just stop for a minute. Come on. I just need like 3 seconds. I gotta set the phone down, unhook her, and then grab the phone again. Lady, just stop. Please, stop. Now she sees somebody across the way over there. So now she thinks that they're, because like people do, they throw treats across the, they throw treats across this ditch. I mean, this is a huge ditch, and people actually throw treats across it to me, for my dogs. So Lady thinks that every person is gonna give her a treat, and so she runs up to everybody, and like some people like get scared, some people, you know, give her a treat, and some people just sort of ignore her. Like, I mean, she's kind of a big dog, people are all scared of her, but she's like the nicest. There we go. All right, here we go. I can get her unhooked. Lady, stop. Just stop for 1 minute. Oh my gosh. That was impossible. I never thought I'd get her unhooked. Now I gotta get her leash out of this tangle mess. They're getting, because they're still getting, like, they're tangling more and more. And it gets to the point where, like, Bowie starts, like, turning in circles because he gets all freaked out that he's gonna choke. So I've gotta get Lady's leash out of this real quick here. Lady, no, you're not gonna chase it, okay? Lady's trying to chase the car thing. She's like over there thinking she's gonna cross the ditch and get it. It's not gonna happen. All right, let me get this. There we go. Get hers out. Put that around my neck. And then the other three are just need to stand still for a minute while I do this, because they don't care about stuff like motorcycles and that kind of shit. Like, they just care about, like, walking around and running around and having fun. So I'm gonna try and take them up to the left and go down that secret side path. It's not a secret, but, you know, it's the path that most people don't go on, so that's why I go there, because I can let them all off the leash to run around. And oh my gosh, I've almost got it. Who needs to be, okay, who's, oh my gosh, Bowie, like, almost tied a knot around it. This is crazy. Okay, there we go. There. Switch it back. There we go. Okay. All right, so, Lady, you ready? Come on. Yeah, come on, sweetie. Come on, there we go. Yeah, see, Lady, Jade wants to play with Lady. This is kind of the place where I used to stop and let them play. I don't really see anybody around, but I don't want to, like, I need to make sure that I'm not going to let them go into somebody. Come on, let's go over this way. Hey, let's go this way. Come on, please, come on, this way, go this way. It's starting to rain a little bit, too, so I kind of want to get this. Blue, I want to let you off the leash, but I can't if you go. See, he wants to walk this way, and I can see somebody. There's somebody down there, so if I let him go, I can't let him go. He is refusing to go. Look at that. He's refusing to go that way. He won't go. He just won't. He's just like, no, I'm not going. I'm not going to do it. Ugh. All right, look, I don't see anybody. I'm just going to let them go for a minute. I'm just going to let these guys go and, like, do their thing for a minute. I got a bag full of treats. I can always get them to come back to me. And I don't have to worry about Lady. I don't need to do it. Like, as long as she doesn't decide she's going to jump in the ditch. I mean, this is deep. Like, we walked across this once, me and Lady both. We walked it together. It was really cool. I wish I would have been able to do stuff like this, like, back then, back when Lady was young. Oh, I got another poop emergency. When Lady was young. Hey, wait. Dude, stay there. Lady, stay there. I don't need them running off while I'm trying to clean up poop. See, Lady just is walking off. She's just walking off on her own. Yeah. So annoying. Like, she's really a good dog, but when she gets something in her mind that she wants to do, there's no stopping her, you know? She's just gonna do it. And there's nothing I can do about it. So, like, yeah, Jade's all running around. Like, now they're all over the place. Try and catch up to all of them. Jade and Lady, I thought they might play. Blue and Jade grew up together. Blue and Jade were puppies together. I actually got Blue because I wanted a friend for Jade, because Lady was already tired of puppies by the time I got Jade. She didn't like her friend that she had grown up with got killed, and so she was never the same after that. Like, after that, it was just me and her, and that's all she cared about. See, Jade wants to play. Jade's crazy. Yeah, Lady never made another attachment with another dog after Cutie died. That was it. Like, it was just me. We would play together. I still play with Lady all the time. We were playing last night after we got home. We were playing, you know, playing the game where I grab her toes and she bites my hand. She really likes that game. She lays on the floor and I grab her toes and then she bites me. And like, I went to the store and I didn't realize like that, like, she'd like been, you know, like, I was, my hand was like bleeding all over, and I was like, oh man. You know, because with the virus and everything, I'm always like, man, people are probably all freaked out. Hey, wait. I got to clean up Lady's poop now. So I didn't realize that she had, like, you know, I had all these puncture marks all over my hand. I don't have much feeling because I'm covered in skin grafts. Most of my skin is skin grafts, so I don't have too much feeling anywhere. So I don't notice stuff like especially, you know, things like that, like, and the cashier asked me what I had tattooed on my fingers, and I was like, oh, I got Lazy tattooed on my fingers, and that was when I saw all the blood, and I was like, oh shoot, that's no good, I can't have all that blood. Like, I got, so I had to figure, like, clean it off real quick. You know, I don't have any other way to clean it off except to, like, lick it off, you know? I have to lick it off my hand. Can you guys wait up? See, this is what happens when all four of them are together. They, like, they're different. They're a pack, and they work as a pack together. And, I mean, they listen to me, but... It's not the same as when I have the, like, another dog with me. Jade is so funny. You're so crazy. Look at you go. I don't know why she doesn't want to come on walks more often. Like, she, like, really likes them, but I can't get her to come with me. She just goes and hides under the bed. I've never understood that. She doesn't know the routine that I do now, though, which is gonna be a problem. I don't want her, because she'll run off. It's a game to her, to, like, she likes to be chased. And I got somebody coming behind me. I gotta get these guys leashed up anyways, because the road's right up here, and this is where I always leash them up. Hey, who wants a treat? Treats, come here. Treats, come here. We got treats coming. Come on, come here. Treats. Hey, Jade, you want a treat? Come here. Come here, come here, come here, come here. Come here, come here. Treats, 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 treats. All right, let me set this down. And let me get the treats for everybody. Yeah, here we go. And then I got to get these guys grabbed up pretty quick here before that person who's walking towards me gets here, because they're walking pretty fast, it looks like. I don't want any trouble. I don't need any trouble today, you know? I have enough problems as it is without somebody telling me, like, that, like, you know, my dogs are off leash and that it's, like, I need to have them on the leash or whatever. Like, it's frustrating to have that. Ah, they're getting so close so fast. Okay, Blue. Lady. Hey, Bowie. Okay, Bowie, you'll take the heart. Dang it. I didn't know it was a heart. Jade, hold on. I gotta get one for Jade. Alright, hold on. Okay, Jade, you gonna take it? No, she won't eat it, though. She won't eat it. So I gotta grab her. Let me grab these three real quick before that person gets here. And then I can get the leash on Lady. I don't have to worry about Lady. She's not gonna run off on me. I just got to get these three grabbed up, the puppies. The young ones, I got to get the young ones picked up. Anybody ever seen The Young Ones on BBC? I love that show. It's so funny. It was like a weird cult hit in America, like with punk rock kids. Okay, lady. You ready? I got to put your leash on. Yeah, I got to get your leash. Lady, come here. Lady, come here. Let me put your leash on. Come here. Come here. Lady, come here. Dang it. She thinks that person has a treat for her. She's going to go over there now. Dang it. It's the last thing I need. And I think this is that guy that I yelled at that one day, too. Lady, come on. Not everybody's got a treat for you. Come on. Come on. Wow, look at that. Look at the sun coming out. It's peeking out over the horizon there. How's it going? Lady, come here. Come here. I got to get your leash on before we go by the road, okay? Wait. Just wait. Just wait. Let me get your leash on. Hold on. Hold on. The road's dangerous. I know for a fact it's dangerous, okay? Not only have I been hit and been hospitalized, but I've seen dogs die multiple times. I've seen cats die. I've seen a lot of bad things happen with roads. Man, like this one night, I was down at the dog park, and we have the highest population of indigenous people in the country. And alcoholism rates in the pueblos and in the indigenous community is about 85%. They're not dangerous or anything. They just want a treat. there's a lot of drunk people around, and there's a park across the street that a lot of people would hang out at and drink, and they would cross the street, and it's right by the freeway where I got hit, and I would watch these guys. They would wander around in the road, almost getting, like, cars would be, like, they just, like, wouldn't even know, like, pay attention to the fact that, like, there were cars coming. And this guy just fell in the road, and he was laying there. I mean, it was, it was so crazy, the stuff I saw. One guy died because these trees are super dangerous. They grow and then they'll just fall apart. I mean, I've seen it happen. It happened at the dog park. There was a big tree there and it crushed the table, the picnic table I was at. Like 30 seconds after I walked away, this tree fell in half, and just like it smashed the concrete, broke, completely smashed the table. Like, if I would have been there, I wouldn't be here right now. So, a tree that happened where, like, a guy was under the tree sleeping, and it fell on him, and he died. One time, this guy, I guess he probably just died of alcoholism, you know what I mean? Like, it was the summer, and it was, like, really hot. And these guys really don't drink a lot of water. And he just died. I watched them put him in a body bag and take him away. It was really crazy. I don't know. Albuquerque is like this place that's like just outrageous. It's so like, it's so different than everywhere else. Ah, shoot, my stupid mask. I always forget about it. Hello. There it is. I gotta get that on. If there's people around. Because everybody's so nervous about this virus. I don't blame them though. I know a guy who just died, you know, that I was watching his dog and he died. I mean, So, I mean, he didn't take it seriously, and he's dead. But see, this is what I'm talking about. The trees, they fall, and they just fall in half. And they just grow out of their roots. But you can see the damage that it does. You can see it completely just fell, and it smashed. They won't stop pulling. I can't get them to stop pulling so I can get a good look at this for a second. Because I know I got to stop the camera for a second. You can see it just fell over onto this garage and smashed the fence and damaged the garage roof and everything. Like, and this is where the coyote lives. There's a coyote that comes and stays there in the, well, pretty soon here. Pretty soon, I'll start seeing coyotes. There should be coyotes around again. This time of year, they start coming into the city because there's no food out in the, so right next to the Rio Grande. The Rio Grande is directly to the left of this direction that I'm looking. If I walked down to this street and took a left and kept going, I would hit the Rio Grande in like probably 20 minutes. And all along it is this park. It's a state forest, and it's called the Bosque. And they come out of there because they run out of food and water and stuff, and they come into the city to find water and food. And then they end up, mating season comes, you know, and then you end up with females making dens and hunting also. We get a lot of wildlife here in the city. It's a really weird. I've never been anywhere like this. There's just so many animals. Like, this is where the raccoon lives. I haven't seen it lately though. But there's no water. See, I always see it when it comes down to get a drink. But if there's no water, you know, it says. I will get it again, but yeah, there's nothing around. I'm coming too late today to catch the peacocks. The peacocks have all gone. They've all gone to roost for the night at this point. So. Oh man, lady is, well, I don't know what is going on with her, but she, look at her, she has got a bug up her ass. She is moving. She is just going so fast. Oh my gosh. I'm really having to like, struggle to keep up here, and I walk fast. All the dogs are just like, see, they all follow Lady. They don't follow me. Blue follows me, but Blue, overall, what Blue does is protect Lady. If Lady's here, he protects her. He watches over her. He's always done that. He's been like, he doesn't protect anybody else. He'll protect me. He protects me and he protects Lady. If Lady's not around, then he's protective of, like Jade. He doesn't protect Bowie because he sees Bowie as like his hunting partner. And he doesn't see him as, an animal. He doesn't think that he needs to be like taken care of because dogs don't seem to, like, pay any attention to, like, oh, Blue, you're gonna pull out of your collar. Come on. Come on. Come on, Blue. Come on. Come on. Not everybody's got a treat for you, man. No, there's no treats. There's no treats. Come on. Sorry. They think you probably have a treat for him. Like, he's trying to, like, they're not mean or anything. You can, like, you can walk past. I mean. Come on. Come on, there's no treat. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, Lady. There's no treat. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Alright. Finally. See, that's what I mean. Like, these people get all like.
Thank you.
upset about, like, my dogs, like, wanting to say hi, you know? They, I don't understand. Like, that's what I mean. Like, these people just, like, refuse to let their dogs come by my dogs for some reason. Because I guess my dogs are super dangerous or something. I don't know. I don't know, like, what their deal is. My dogs have no mean intentions. But it's always been that way down here. Like people do that with me. They don't do it with other people. They just do it with me mostly. They all keep away from me. I mean, the people who give me treats, like those, I ran into that old guy who's got the dog with cancer too, like, who walks his dog down here all the time, and he gives the dogs treats. I ran into them, the one of the ladies lives where I live, and so I run into them sometimes, when I'm leaving to go on the dog walks, and they always have treats. I always have treats. It's too late probably to catch the, there's that place down here where there's 5 dogs, and it's probably too late for that. So they're gonna get all barky with each other. No, don't get all, no, Blue, don't get all barky. Come on. Yeah, I know. Come on, it's okay. Come on. Hey. Bowie is the worst one. He's crazy as heck. Like, look at him. He's just like, he like spins in circles and stuff. He wants to like, he's just so aggressive. I don't understand it. He's a crazy dog. Like, he's like, he's the one who like gets Blue all like riled up, you know? Like, Blue is fine, just walking along. He's totally fine. And then like, Bowie will start going crazy, and then Blue, of course, like, you know, he can't help it. His dog brain is like, well, I gotta help my friend, and so pack mentality kicks in, and Lady will run away. Like, she just takes off and runs away. Like, she doesn't want anything to do with any fights whatsoever. Come here, Lady. So, come here, Lady, come here. Come on. Oh, man. Let me get these guys untangled real quick here. Oh, my gosh. All right. Hold on. I've got to get you untangled. Hold on. Let me put Lady's leash over my head and get you guys untangled. Hold on. Hold on. Let me get you guys a handle. There's that go-kart down here. I'm a little worried about that. So I'm probably going to have to put the leashes back on before I get to the go-kart, because otherwise, like, Lady will, like, run up to it or something. I don't know. Something bad will happen. I know it. I just know it. Ugh. Oh, my gosh. So, oh man, so I'm listening to Kimya Dawson, and she's singing this song about, like, kind of like what it was like to be in, like, middle school, and that made me think of those books, like Flowers in the Attic. I always remember, like, in middle school, all these girls were always reading V.C. Andrews books. And when I was traveling, I would read a lot, and I came across a copy of Flowers in the Attic. I didn't know anything about it. It's one of the most horrific stories I've ever read. And then I've actually read some of the... I read one of the books that comes after it, but it's about these four kids that get locked in an attic, and the brother and sister end up having sex and falling in love, and they have a kid, and then they all escape, and the brother is like, it's so crazy, like this crazy grandma locks him up there, and she's trying to poison him. She's trying to kill him with cookies. She gives him these cookies, and apparently she's putting like cyanide or something in the sugar. And like she's trying to kill these four kids that live in the, they're trapped in the attic. Their whole world is just an attic. They grow up there. You know, it's freaking nuts. Like I I'm thinking back on how like what does that do to, like, you know what I mean? Like, what does that do to a 12-year-old's mind? You know, like these to be reading that kind of stuff is just, I had no idea. And everybody seems to think it's okay. Like, if I had a kid, there's no way in hell my kid would ever read a V.C. Andrews book until they were like 21, if it was up to me. Because that is some very mature material. Like, I mean, it's full of like brutality, incest, you know? Like, well, what is that called? Matricide, you know, it's just like all these like really heavy issues, you know, I just had to talk about that for a second, because it's just one of those things that like I find so weird that everybody seems to think it's normal. I don't know if it's still, like, you know what I mean? Like, if those books are still popular, or if, like, I know, the, like, the Twilight books came along, and maybe, you know, like, they probably took the place of those V.C. Andrews books. But that was what was, like, the thing when I was in middle school, was Flowers in the Attic and all the sequels. Horrible, horrible book. Oh, my gosh. And I like to read, and if I'm gonna read fiction, you know, I think it should at least have like a point or a moral or something. But it doesn't. It doesn't have any moral, any point, anything. It's just like because the brother and sister, because like they grow up, get jobs, raise their kid, and it's all normal. Like, there's no warnings about, like, incest or anything. Like, there's no, like, they don't ever, like, make it seem like any of the stuff that happens in there is bad. It's all okay, you know? Everything is okay. And I'm just so amazed by stuff like that. That, like, you know, I mean, the book, most of the time when I read stuff, It's got, you know, the books. I read a lot of nonfiction also. I actually read more nonfiction than fiction. The fiction I read it's pretty rare, but it, you know, I mean, like, it has, like, you know, a moral to the story and that kind of thing. It's not like these, like, weird, like, moralist stories about, you know, killing children and brothers and sisters having babies and stuff. Like, I'm kind of amazed that that stuff was ever popular or published even. So I don't know, but I guess you know that's the kind of thing. I guess it sells, right? I mean, for yourselves. Fuck, phone's ringing and I can't answer it. It's probably my mom. I need to order pizza tonight because she doesn't want to cook, so I need to make sure that, I don't know what time it is exactly. Let's see. What time is it? Time? What time is that? Did that? What does that say? Five? Oh, it's 5:01. So I gotta get that pizza ordered. I have the I got the Domino's pizza app on my phone. So I usually just that's what I just have it set, like it's all preset to order. I just hit like, you know, the button, and then there's a Domino's, like I literally, it's like I could just walk over and pick it up. But carrying a pizza with one arm is one of those things that I have a really hard time doing, and I don't know, I can't do it. Like I drop stuff like that because the boxes are all slippery and stuff. Usually I can carry pretty much anything. How's it going? Oh man, hang on, lady, I'm coming. I wish I could have let the dogs run around one more time. They really like to play right here. They go, they like Jade and Blue usually like go crazy here. Blue is on the trail of something. I don't know what, he'll do stuff like that just so he'll like drag me. Like he like pulls so hard too. Like he pulls like with all his might. Just so he can pee on something. He smells like some other dog's pee. He wants to make sure that he gets it first, you know? Gotta stop for Blue. Blue the Wonder Dog. This dog pees. I don't know how he had like pees all the time. He's always peeing. Like, he never runs out. Like, the other dogs run out. Like, he does not run out. Ever. He's always, like, he's like full. He must be like full of pee. Like head to toe, it must be all pee. He's just like one giant bladder. Yeah, lady, we're gonna do the treats. Yeah, we're gonna do the treats. Yes, we are. That's right. Just gotta get down here. I wanna let her go through the fence. Just, it's hard for her to go over this with her back leg. Like, I have a stool that I use so that she can get up on the couch. Because it's really hard for her to get up there anymore. Okay, yeah, let's do some treats right here. Yeah, let's do some treats right here. Let's do some treats. All right, here we go. All right, here we go. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Do the treats, come here. All right, lady, let me get your leash on first. Let me get lady's leash. Hold on, we're going to do treats, okay? Hold on. See, I don't have any treats that Jade likes, so I don't know, like, how to keep her from running off. Except, like, I just have to stand on her leash, because otherwise, man, there's nobody else around. Otherwise, Jade will just run off, because she doesn't like these treats. Every dog in the world likes these treats, except her. She's so picky, she'll only eat, like, those, like, beef sticks. It's like about the only thing she'll eat. Here, Jade, what about that one? See, I have all these like treats and she won't eat them. There you go, lady. There you go. Here, I'll break this in half. And I'll give half to Bowie and half to Blue. And then another one to Lady. And hey, stay here. Stay here. I'm gonna grab their leashes. Well, I can't. Blue, come here. There you go, buddy. I gotcha. Okay. I just gotta grab Jade and then Lady. And then the phone. Your niece. Quietly to the camp. Oh man. Okay, so I've got the dogs all leashed up for the final, this is the final stretch, the walk home. Here we go, let's do it. I always like the walk home. I like mountains. I really like mountains. I've been to quite a few, national parks, and then a lot of like state parks. Like I've camped there. way up, like, you know, like 10,000 feet up, where like in the middle of summer there was snow. But it was weird because it would get up to like, during the day, it'd be like 90 degrees. And then you know, everybody would be grabbing the snow and making, you know, slushies out of it or whatever. But then at night, like as soon as the sun went down, boom, it would drop to like it would be like freezing. It would literally drop to like 32 degrees or less. And it would do it in about 30 minutes. So like you had to make sure that you knew what time it was and that you had your winter clothes with you, because if you didn't, man, like you could easily freeze to death up there. There's no help anywhere. You know what I mean? Like you have to go like miles down to get help. And I remember like people would like get all like fucked up and they'd wander off into the off the trails, and you know everybody would say like, look, don't ever go off the trails, you know, never go off the trails. And they go off the trails and they would fall down like a cliff or something and they break their leg, and then everybody'd have to like find a way to like climb down and get this crazy person who's probably, you know, they're usually high on like mushrooms or acid or something, and just like, I don't know, they got lost, turned around, and next thing they know, they're like in a world of pain, having the worst trip of their lives, you know, being carried by four hippies out of a national forest. Like that would be like a fucking nightmare. God damn, just being carried by hippies alone is a nightmare. Like I'm not a big fan of hippies. They're really full of themselves, you know. I don't know how, if you don't have any experience with hippies, like this is the way they are. Like they just like there's a whole group of them and they travel the country, you know, all the time. That's all they do, is travel the country. And go from like park to parks, and they all claim that like they live there, they've left Babylon. Babylon is, you know, the cities, and that they are come on, let's go, and that they're on their own and they take care of themselves and all this stuff. Well, it turns out that all of them are on food stamps. And that's mostly how they get their food, because they set up kitchens that are free, and so you can go out to any kitchen and get food. But see, the thing is that it all comes from food stamps, and they're like drug dealers. I mean, there's hippie buses, and they're brewing meth on them and stuff like that. Like. Two buses got busted at one time, at the last gathering I went to. Two buses got busted for meth. I mean, they steal. They go into the cities. There's usually a city nearby, and they go there and they panhandle, they steal. You know, they're not living like they didn't get out of Babylon. Like, they're just, like, basically, they're just fucking leeches. They don't contribute anything to society. All they do is take and take and take and live for free in national forests and parks and state parks and shit. And they've got all these, like, super, like, ACLU lawyers to defend their rights to be there. But, you know, everywhere they go, they just cause, like, havoc. You know, they are, though, I gotta say, they're really good about cleaning up. Like, I would always stay till, like, most people leave after the 4th of July. The 4th of July is, like, the big day. That's, like, this big deal where there's the national park and, you know, that you're at. And it's called the National Gathering. There's like regional gatherings, you know, there's like little tiny gatherings. And then there's like regional gatherings, and then there's the national that happens once a year for the 4th of July. Well, all these college kids come, and they come just for drugs. You know, it's just a party. Like there's a lot of people, like a lot of people from the town will come up. Like, you know, people who are younger will come up and you know, hang out, and they just get all fucked up too. And they just throw their garbage everywhere. And so a lot of us would, like me, I would stay and I would clean up. We would clean up all the garbage. We would walk around and we walk around all the trails and you know, check all around everywhere we could find and make sure that we cleaned up everything, that we didn't leave any garbage behind. And if you were one of those people, you'd always be guaranteed a ride to the next place, you know, or at least a ride. For me, it was just, I just wanted to get the fuck out. I was tired of hippies by that point. Like, I couldn't take any more of them. I was about to fucking lose my mind. Every time, people always talk me into going to the gathering. Like, I know what I'm going to find when I get there. Like, I'm going to find a bunch of fucking dirty idiots who think they are better than everyone else. But I end up there, and of course, is that it? I got it. There we go. I got it. Okay. Blew out a goat head again. There we go. So, yeah, that's why I ended up. I mean, I liked the camping, but I could have died. Like, see, for me, it was about the camping. I would always find a campsite, like, off by myself, away from everyone else, because I didn't want to, like, you know, I didn't want to deal with all the fuck. Because you could, like, you could stay at, like, anywhere you wanted, it basically. You could lay down and set up camp anywhere, anywhere. I mean, nobody would tell you, like, not to. So, like, I would just go find a camp, like, off by myself somewhere, usually by, like, a river or a stream or something, so that I could get my own water and boil it, you know? Because you have to boil it, all these people would just drink the river water and the stream water, and they would get this thing called Giardia, and it's from like the animals pooping in the rivers and stuff. They get stop poking lady with that stick. lady just snapped on Bowie. He's got this stick in his mouth and he kept poking her in the face with it. So I wish that you could see this better. I like this view of the mountain when I'm going back, especially this time of day. I like night. Like, I really like getting up in at like, you know, like three, you know, not three, but four in the morning and going out when there's nobody around, and it's just all quiet, and it's beautiful. Like, but you know, I don't really like, you know, I don't like people. I don't understand them. I just don't know. I just, you know what I mean? I just don't fit. I just don't know how to fit. So, never have. I was born that way. You know, it was like, somehow my brain, you know, I'm really smart. Like, every therapist and counselor and psychiatrist, whatever, they've all been like, dude, you are really, really smart. So, that's great. So basically, like, I lost all of my, you know, like, natural, like, abilities to be social and to get along with other people, to know how, like, it's not that I don't want to, it's not that I don't want to be, like, friends with people and stuff, it's just that I don't know how, and I always say the wrong thing, and then it's all screwed up, and they get mad at me, and I don't know why. So, oh, I hate all these cars. So scary. Oh my gosh. So, Yeah, so, I mean, I got all this intelligence and no social skills, and it's horrible. So I hang out, you know, that's why I just hang out with dogs and by myself and gaming. Like, video, like this, like, that's, like, the only things that, like, really, like, I need, like, something to preoccupy my mind with puzzles, and gaming is basically, like, one long puzzle. You're trying to figure out how to solve all these different things in order to get to the end, you know, and complete the story. And so it's like I need like that, or building computers and, like, you know, that kind of stuff. I'm totally drawn to it. I always have been. I've always taken everything apart and put it back together again. And I had more fun doing that, like, than like playing with toys. I like taking them apart. I didn't really like, people would buy me, like, all these, like, Star Wars toys and stuff. I had a whole bunch of them, but I didn't really, like, I don't have an imagination, and I know that's, like, hard to, imagine for people. I have no art skills, no imagination. I can barely draw, like, a smiley face, you know? Like, seriously, I am so, like, I'm 100% left brain, like, no right brain at all. Like, I am just incapable of, any sort of, so I'd have these toys, these Star Wars toys, and I didn't know what to do with them, because, like, you know, you see them in the movie, and you'd want the toy, because you look cool, like, in the movie. But then I didn't know how to, like, I just didn't know how to play. Like, I didn't like, Legos was about the only thing that I really enjoyed, because I could keep taking it apart and making new things. One box of, you know, a spaceship was, like, you know, a million different spaceships. I could just keep taking it apart and making new spaceships. So Legos were always, like, I loved Legos. They were so expensive that I could, you know, I usually could only get, like, those little tiny sets that aren't very good. Well, this is pretty much it. The sun's going down, and I'm getting home, and I got to get that pizza ordered. So I really hope that I get the pizza ordered and stuff before my mom gets home. Because otherwise she's going to be really mad. Alright. So, well, I guess I'm just going to stop it right here. There's not much, there's like nothing else to see. I just got to get the dogs inside and get that pizza ordered quick. So, alright. Here we go. Goodbye, everybody.